Now we are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains long before we knew we could. It's hard to kill. Who knows what miracle?
By Ferenc, Dialogical Tenets of Humility, Faith, Hope, Critical Thinking, and Solidarity, I conducted an audio record of a case study interview with an educational leader to illustrate how he utilized transformative educational leadership to intervene and thereby effect academic and social improvement in an educational institution. The interview focuses on some of the important interventions that the transformative leader effected. According to PASS 1985, a transformational leader works with teams to identify needed change, creating a vision to guide the change through inspiration, and executing the change in tandem with committed members of the group. Idealized attributes, idealized behaviors, inspirational motivation, intellectual stimulation, and individualized consideration are considered to be transformational leadership behaviors. On the other hand, Soto 2014 notes that the concept of social justice involves finding the optimum balance between our joint responsibilities as social agents and our responsibilities as individuals to contribute to a just society. Social justice involves responsibility to address systemic or structural poverty, inequality, and unfairness. The research was qualitative in nature in the form of interview with an audio recording being used to capture the proceedings. The participant was purposefully selected based on his contributions towards transformation for social justice and his potential to change the society. The school is a technical high school that is located in a black township of Katlehong in Ekurhuleni district of Gauteng province in South Africa. Poverty, crime, and unemployment are high in the community. Most of the learners come from single-parent-headed families, while some families are either headed by a grandparent or another sibling. Majority of the teachers are black, with a few non-whites. The languages taught in the school are isiZulu, Tsonka, these are the home languages, and English as the first additional language. My transformational leader is Mr. Opperman, the principal of Katlehong Technical High School. He's originally from Germiston and is married to a police officer, and they are blessed with one daughter. Mr. Opperman holds a bachelor's honors degree in educational management, law, and police from University of Pretoria, amongst other qualifications. Mr. Opperman has worked in Germiston as a physical science educator. He rose to the position of HOD being promoted to the deputy principal at the age of 31. 3 years later, he was promoted to the position of principal at Katlehong Technical High School. According to Mr. Opperman, when he joined the school, he was faced with challenges such as learner underperformance, learner and teacher discipline, poor infrastructure such as toilets, offices, and staff rooms, as well as shortages of teaching and learning resources. Mr. Opperman used analysis of the school results from grade 8 to 12 to make both the SGB and SMT to understand the position of the school. This culminated in the formulation of a clear school vision and teams that would steer the strategy to achieve the shared vision. As a sign of showing faith and seeking solidarity, The vision was shared with learners and teachers, as well as relevant stakeholders, so that everybody understands and works towards it. Performance targets were shared and activities that were appropriate were put in place and communicated to all stakeholders. All the stakeholders were encouraged to transcend their own self-interest for the sake of the team and the school. By delegating monitoring duties to his two deputies and the HODs, the principal has managed to develop leadership capacities in the school, moving beyond focusing on the day-to-day operations and expanding decision-making processes to focus on long-term strategies. The principal has elevated ladies to leadership positions of HOD, and the number of non-black teachers in the school has risen as a way of trying to achieve social justice. Mr. Opperman understands that women's presence in leadership and girls' educational participation are key indicators of a more progressively democratic society and productive economy, because women and girls are carriers of cultures and indicative of inclusivity in social life. Issues such as learner discipline, late coming, and absenteeism have been addressed through collaboration with parents and all teachers. As the leader, the principal has shown courage by taking the calculated risks, making tough decisions by reshuffling, and sometimes hiring appropriate staff in line with the provisions of achieving the school targets. Some teachers have been forced to transfer for performance that is not aligned to his vision. Based on his personal passion, Mr. Opperman has inspired the staff to buy into this vision and execute it on all levels of the school. He's always motivating his staff and is known for leading by example. He interacts with both learners and the students. He realizes that the impact of a simple hello in the hallway or conversation with the learners and everyone else will make them feel important. His personal conduct and dress has set a standard for the school, with improved security and monitoring through CCTV cameras, secure fence, a secure park, and security in the school. New offices and a furnished staff room have been put in place as a way of improving infrastructure. An outside study area for learners, especially grade 12, has been erected. Through arriving early and standing at the gate, the principal has managed to improve learner discipline by setting an example. He has also been attending workshops and studies, and this has encouraged all the other teachers to follow suit. Upon realizing the levels of poverty in the community, the principal has formed partnerships with local sponsors to support the school through school uniform, breakfast for learners, and NGOs who offer weekend classes for both learners and adult literacy and numeracy classes. He managed to form partnerships with companies such as BMW and VW to train former learners in technical schools. A driving school and a computer programming project ensures that learners acquire certificates and life skills as they enter into the real world. This has helped reduce unemployment and crime in the school. Partnerships with the police have helped to reduce crime both within and around the school. As a transformative intellectual, Mr. Opperman has managed to critically examine this institution with a view of eliminating social inequalities and bringing transformation through both teachers and parents. He understands that teachers have the potential to be transformative intellectuals, and they can combine scholarly reflection and practice in the service of educating students to be critical thinkers who participate in informed democracy. He also believes that teachers are key contributors to the transformation of education in South Africa only if they are qualified, competent, dedicated, and caring. The teachers will be able to play various roles to produce learners who act in the interests of a society based on respect for democracy, equality, human dignity, and social justice. He has done all this through critical thinking, humility, faith, and solidarity with all stakeholders. But as the norm with any institution, Mr. Opperman has faced challenges of resistance to change. However, through negotiation, patience, persistence, and delegation of powers, he has managed to win the hearts of men.